हेलो एवरीवन, सो एज़ यू आर सेइंग दैट टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ फैराडे एक्सपेरिमेंट विच इज़ रिलेटेड टू द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फेनोमेना. हेयर यू आर सेइंग दैट फैराडे एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो दिस वेल इज़ राउंड राउंड इज़ व्हाट द कॉयल विच इज़ मेड बाय द सम टाइप ऑफ कंडक्टर एंड दिस इज़ द वायर विच इज़ कनेक्टेड टू ए गैल्वेनोमीटर. सो गैल्वेनोमीटर हैव द इनिशियल वैल्यू ज़ीरो and after that right and left the same type of meter is there. So having the some distance, the magnet is placed here. In magnet there is a south pole and there is a north pole. Initially the magnet have the velocity zero, means to say that it is in rest. So Faraday observed during this experiment a very interesting phenomena. Today we will concentrate over this. This is really a very interesting and important topic for upcoming topics and as well as for the today. The understanding the very well this, we will concentrate over the deflection shown in galvanometer. So what is the galvanometer? Galvanometer is a device which is used to measure the amount of deflection of current due to the current that the pointer will be deflected, and if it deflect towards the right or towards the left, it shows the direction of the current also. So galvanometer is a device which is used to detect the small amount of current in a circuit as well as the direction of the current. Here you are seeing that there is a coil is placed in this galvanometer, and this is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal, and it is on off switch. So that is what our galvanometer. If we see in manually, if we see in this, that is the galvanometer placed symbolically in the circuit. The symbol is galvanometer is this one. So initially we will see that the our magnet is in rest. So if we see in the this galvanometer, that galvanometer that is our magnet. Initially you have seen that the magnet in our your earlier classes, that is the magnet, okay. So that magnet is not go inside that coil, or it will show the small deflection, okay. So it will show the deflection. So I have another type of a strong magnet. It's little bit, you can say the different type of cell, you can say the cylindrical one, that is the rectangular one, both are the magnet. As you know that both have the reflection and deflection due to the magnetic properties. So both are the magnet. So this is also a magnet and that is also a magnet. So I am using the cylindrical magnet. That cylindrical magnet, when in rest, there is no deflection. So cylindrical magnet is when in rest, there is no deflection. As you are seeing that in galvanometer, the pointer is showing the zero. So zero error ke saath, the zero value is showing inside the indicator, or you can say the measuring scale. So whenever they move this magnet, it will start to deflect. So in step two, we have the velocity of the magnet. Velocity of the magnet towards the coil where the galvanometer is connected. So in this step 3, you are saying that the deflection of the galvanometer take place. If the deflection is taking place, then definitely there is a current. Initially there is no induced current inside the coil, but when we start to move the coil, current will show the deflection in the galvanometer. It means that coil having the some type of induced current inside it. See, in experiment, in activity, we can see that is the magnet. If I move it, the deflection you will see here. So deflection is there. It means to say that inside that coil, that is the coil, our coil, it is having the induced current due to the motion of this magnet as well as. So either you can move the coil or you can move the magnet, but there must be a relative motion. There must be a relative motion between magnet or in the coil. So if the relative motion is present there, there will be an induced current. If the direction, or you can say the direction of velocity is changed, initially the velocity is towards the magnet, and the step 3, the velocity is away from the magnet. Velocity is away from the magnet. If the magnet go away from the magnet, away from the coil, the direction of current will change. The direction in galvanometer current is changed. So that is what Faraday want to say, that the relative motion between the coil as well as the direction of the coil, as well as direction of the coil and the magnet, which decide the direction of the current. if we put the south pole here and the north pole here, then the direction will be opposite, the direction will be reversed. So if the north pole is there and it is going towards the magnet, the direction will be towards the right inside the galvanometer. Inside the galvanometer, direction will be right if the north pole is towards this one. So direction will be right, and when the magnet will come out, the direction will be towards the left. The direction will be towards the web. Let's see with the magnet. Initially, you are seeing in the meter there is no deflection, and I start to move this magnet relative to that coil, the deflection will take place. The deflection will take place. Initially, it will go, and if I put it in the rest inside the magnet, there is no deflection. See this magnet inside the coil. Magnet inside the coil. Magnet inside the coil. There is no deflection in the galvanometer. It means to say that the relative motion must be between them. If the relative motion is there, then the deflection is there. Deflection means to then the induced current is there. So whatever work we are doing over this magnet, that is converting into the electrical energy. That is what? Electric current. So deflection is just because of the we are doing work over this magnet. Due to that relative motion is done by the work. So that work is converted into the form of energy, and that energy is showing the deflection inside the galvanometer. That is what induced current. That is what induced current. So initially the current, whenever we are in rest, either inside the magnet, either inside the coil or outside the coil, if we are in rest, there is no deflection inside the galvanometer. If there is a relative motion between the coils, there will be a deflection, as you see. As you see, the pointer is vibrating towards left and right, because the magnet is going inside and outside. The relative motion is what? The magnet is going inside and outside. If the magnet is go inside and outside, if magnet go inside the outside of the magnet coil, then deflection will take place. If we stopped it, if we stop the motion of a magnet, the there is no deflection in the galvanometer. It means there is no current present, there is no induced current present inside the coil. That what the Faraday want to say, that due to this experiment there is a revolutionary results come, and the whole environment of electrical production, yeah, electricity production is changed. So Faraday done a very great job to you can say that efficiently producing the current, as well as you can say reducing the current of, otherwise the current is the product, or the current is the energy which related to the you can say that for few pupils in the world. But due to this experiment, the current will go everywhere in the world in 18th century 18 to 19. So it is around the 1867 that we have observed the Faraday done the very great job in this our electric environment and scenario. This coil is also used to convert the electrical energy into the mechanical energy, and the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. So that is what our the dummy of generator. So here is a coil. If you see that inside this, there is a coil. That is the coil. So that is the coil. This coil is same as the coil in the galvanometer. So if we relatively move in the magnet, magnet is here, north pole and south pole is placed are here. So that is the permanent magnet inside this setup. And if we move with the help of this, there is a handle, there is a handle. If we start to move this one, this will produce a relative motion. This will produce the relative motion inside the generator, and then generator start to produce the light, or you can say that light energy, or you can say the presence of energy. That is the on off switch. So this is what we are trying to do here, that electromagnetic induction is a phenomena which it shows that relative motion, the magnet will produce a amount of current. It means to say that the motion of magnet, yeah, magnetic field of magnet intersect the coil, there will be a induced current inside the coil. It is proved by the Faraday with this experiment. Thank you very much for joining.